gives me great pleasure to introduce Ms. Bhagyashree Sathe, Deputy Director. She represents MSME Development Institute, Mumbai, which provides MSMEs various types of extension services and assistance in setting up of units, promoting and developing products and services. The Institute has technical officers to provide guidance in all trades. It was established in 1954 as a small industry service institute. So I request Ms. Bhagyashree to please come on stage and say a few words.
I could see the balanced crowd out here. There are students in majority plus the MSME friends. And even I am considerably new to MSME because I have recently joined this ministry as a development institute in MSME's development institute at Sakinaka. So it actually gives me immense pleasure to be all year round with all of you, because in this age where I could see the young crowd sitting out here with the middle-aged people who are full of experiences here. So in this age of competition and innovation, I think this crowd has the key to do it. They are the key makers, because this innovation is something which comes from a lot from the young blood, and we need them. If I have to say, Honorable Prime Minister had announced many of the schemes like Make in India. For MSMEs, there is like zero effect, zero defect. These are all big terms sometimes, actually have a long vision. That vision actually goes up to the huge crowd, which is the new blood, which is here with us. If we just see around, I think there are around 16 lakhs graduates, not graduates if I really term into, engineers, polytechnics, MBAs, management students coming out every year, more than 16 lakh maybe. And how much jobs are being created, I won't be commenting upon that. But if I have to say, how many of them actually go into startups? If I say something like 10%, I would be really wrong. I would dare to comment upon 5%. I take that there. Okay, 5% of them goes into startups. But from the 16 lakhs, remaining are still into the job hunt, which is not going to serve any purpose. So I request everyone to start thinking upon these lines, because overall intention of what is in Make in India or Stand Up India, Startup India, it's all lies in creating the employment avenues in our own country. And that is why these startups, when they are going to grow in us, they are actually going to give us the employment. That is why they are very important. So to begin, I think if I now need to really talk about like MSMEs, what Ministry of MSME is doing, what is our institute all about, there are various schemes which actually keep coming. There are existing, they are supporting the businesses. And in our institute, the institute has been introduced. There are many technical officers who are assisting, who are giving support, hand-holding to various new beginners, even not about just new beginners, who are existing players. For any consultancy, they are always available at our office at Sakinaka. So regarding MSMEs, if there is any doubt or query, you can definitely visit our office. And if I need to talk about something like current wave, so I'll just go, take you a bit back to the time zone. Like the public procurement policy which was out from the MSMEs. So in that policy, there was something very much crucial, was there was a 20% reservation for MSMEs. in central government procurements and PSUs that are actually made a way for MSMEs to find out their own way. Actually, बैसाखियों पर चला नहीं जा सकता, लेकिन support जो होता है, उसके लिए मैं कहूँगी कि policy में बहुत अच्छा है, and it's being implemented very nicely, so it's there for you all. And to promote MSMEs, like when these new startups come up, they want to have their own market, they need to explore the world, to build up the contacts, and you know better than me, I'm still new. So MSME as a ministry is actually providing financial support for going to different international trade fairs, domestic trade fairs, and you can avail that easily. There's on the website of DCMSME, everything is available. So that can be, that facility can be used. And to say that now, with the slogan of ease of doing business, MSMEs is actually going from informal sector to formal sector. As we all know, MSMEs are having a considerable significant amount of percentage into the GDP, and I think most of you, you will be studying all around, you would be aware of that. And with that is also added that it's into informal sector more than a formal sector, at least in terms of numbers, if we are counting them. So if we really need to, when this ease of doing business was brought in, the whole idea was to simplify the process. And with that, I think the Udyog Aadhaar was introduced. And it is very nice, which has replaced the entrepreneur's memorandum when you used to have it filed part one, then part two, then so long. So it has been now very simple. It's now in none of your time, I think in 5 to 10 minutes, your Udyog Aadhaar is in front of your screen. It's all online business. And you could see the certificate. There's no need of any hard copy or anything. So that is what ease of doing business is. At least visible, you can feel it. And with that, there are many changes. Like recently, what we are talking about is the change in the definition of MSMEs. The definition which was existing, which was based on the investment in plant and machinery, that has been changed into the annual turnover. But still, there is a cabinet approval to it. The notification yet to be out. So till the time we are still following the what is the existing definition, but it has been approved by the cabinet. Let's see when the notification is out for it. And with that itself, with the change in definition, it's also promoting the ease of doing business, which I am continuously repeating it out. And this would be definitely having a this change in the norms in the classification of MSMEs is definitely seen as providing good growth pave for the increased business, and it's a welcoming change, and people are looking forward to it. And definitely, it would, if the MSMEs are benefited, it would be going to increase the direct or indirect employment, the whole idea. And there is something like RBI has also introduced a new the NPA limits from 90 days to 180 days. So that is also, the proposed decision is also seems to be welcoming to all our MSME players. So there are things coming in. I would really love to see the students here, because the basic purpose of our institute is to promote and support the new generation who is right sitting out here to come up. We are ready to give you the hand-holding support, how to get the credit facilities, how to get the marketing assistance. There are some schemes. So just come up to the institute. We are definitely will be helping out you there, and it is what is the future for tomorrow. Then going for a job hunt, have it your own. जैसे अभी मेरे पहले जो स्पीकर्स थे उन्होंने कहा था खुद का जब धंधा करते हैं तो उसमें ज़्यादा मज़ा आता है. दैट इज़ व्हाट इट इज. आई थिंक आई विल फिनिश इट अप. एंड
आई रिक्वेस्ट एनीबॉडी टू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस फॉर such an any person who is here to help you, any students, any MSMEs who have any questions regarding MSMEs, please come up. You don't get an opportunity to meet the deputy director very easily, so take the opportunity and just sit there. Come, anybody for questions, please. Mike,
ma'am. Yeah. Good morning. My name is Ritwik Singh and I'm into training engineering students for public speaking and confidence building. So what I have seen throughout colleges in Maharashtra, especially 2-tier, 3-tiers, students are lacking motivation for starting of their own. They already feel disadvantaged because of certain influences. And what I've also known that they have very less knowledge about MSME startups, right? So ma'am, is there any platform where students can go to or if you conduct some, monthly or weekly training, so that at least if they are in third year or fourth year of their engineering, they can actually think about it. So, is there any platform or connection?
Yeah, there are EDP programs, entrepreneurship development programs, which are conducted on regular basis in our institute. So, I request them to just have it come and enroll in our institute, so that whenever our next program would be out, they would be attend at various places. It's not just ki Mumbai mein hota hai, har jagah hota hai Maharashtra mein. So jahan pe wo unke liye suitable ho, they can come and attend those programs there. And the basic purpose and the motive is what you are saying. We are also concerned for that. We are here to make them entrepreneurs. We will guide them. Aisa nahi hai ki wo ek 4 mahine ka ya 3 hafte ka program attend karke aap entrepreneurs ban jate hai, aisa nahi hai. At least you will get some direction. That is what is the whole purpose. आपके दिल में होना चाहिए, जिगर में होना चाहिए.
So ma'am, is there any particular schedule like this many date in a month, or is there any start like?
Yeah, there is a schedule.
Okay.
I think after the mass, from the month of May, it would be starting.
Okay.
At that time, it would be uploaded. Some of them are put online. Some of them, sometimes what happens, they are scheduled at a short notice, then it could not be done on online. But you can just ring it up on the office numbers.
Okay.
It would be guided.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Yeah.